Hi, I'm ZimZoe, and this is day 6 of our Ty Mawr Towyn Holiday. And today's footage might be a little on the short side because I've done nothing. Lazed around in the caravan for most of the day. I mean, I went swimming this morning for several hours, and went to the arcades in the afternoon. So I've got some footage from the arcades, but it's highly likely that I'm going to be combining this with the day 7 stuff. But for those of you who are watching it sequentially, you'll want to hear about Day 5's entertainment in the evening. And so I will, because they had Soul Station on again, which is the show. But this time they only had 4 people in it. And although I was in a better seat this time, like I was closer to the stage, and so there wouldn't be people walking in front of me and this, that and the other, I didn't bother filming it, because I thought, I've already got one, and I liked it with the 5 people more. But I was close enough to get a high five so that when the people who ran onto the dance floor, Troopers, Zach and Tommy ran onto the dance floor, they gave high fives to the people on the front row. But yeah, I didn't film that. However, Yellow Team, which was our side of the room, won for Madness and Mayhem. And I helped out get 150 points. Because they were doing this, like, say what you see minigame, which is on the screens. They'd show some sort of cryptic clue and you had to work it out. It was a lot like Catchphrase, like the old TV show. Or the game Dingbats, if you've ever played that. It's a board game. And so I managed to get one of those. I managed to help with the first one. Because the troopers had to run from the stage to the seats, get the answer, and then run back again. So I helped with the first one. And then helped with the second one, and then the third one, they were like saying, okay, well, this next person's got to be someone with glasses. And the guy who sat at the table next to me was sort of like, yeah, you're wearing glasses, this is good. But then the next one was, it's got to be a guy with a full pint or like a full drink in his hand. So I was like, well, I can't apply to this one. And it was good too, because I didn't know it. And then the last one was at the back of the room. But yeah, I helped get 150 points by getting 3 answers right. And I also won something else by partaking in the party dances of an evening, because whoever's the best dancer of the night, the most put the most effort in and this, that, the other, they win themselves a little something something. And so what their quote was is, it's a lady on the far side of the dance floor in the black t-shirt, for putting in, like, giving a hair all from beginning to end and loving every second of it. And I was just like, yes! So at least I've got a souvenir to take home with me. Anyway, I'll let you see the footage from the rest of the day now. Oh, not backwards. No, not again.
my god.
Yes!
Oh, oh god.
Suddenly it's day 7. I told you there wasn't much footage from day 6, but I can tell you about the entertainment from day 6. We had a comedian last night called Noel Brody, who started with something that I was like, not over keen on, because it was a lot of sexual innuendos using like phrases from kids' shows so that the kids wouldn't understand what was going on. And I was very sort of, no, this isn't my sort of humour. But, he turned around, he said during one part of the show that it's not his aim to get everybody laughing at all the time. He likes to work in like small groups of five. And so that way everybody in the audience gets to laugh at something or other in his show. And I thought, well, yeah, that works. And it worked for me as well, because it got a lot funnier later in the show when he was talking about some other subjects, such as like different places in the UK, accents, different ages. There was also a bit of like a PC talk and stuff like that. That's political correctness, not computers. Anyway, I thought that was quite good. We also did a Disney quiz yesterday, and I'm gonna try and find the sheet so you can see the score that we got. Got it! And here we are. Yes, the last quiz we did was more sports themed, so we didn't do very well on that at all. But yesterday, as I said, was Disney themed, and 20 out of 20. Now, there was one that the person I was with, she turned around and said, well, I would have gotten them all as well, but no, I got number 8, and not many people knew that one, which was, what film does Wally like to watch over and over? And the only reason I knew that is because I like one of the songs from the soundtrack, and couldn't find it on the Wally soundtrack, and so I had to find the film that it was from, which was just pure luck. But anyway, we won. It was... there was 20 questions, got 20 out of it, and there was 4 people that won. So each person that won themselves one of these. And just in case you were thinking, oh, she's just holed up the same bottle from last time, from the party dancers, quiz. So I do have some souvenirs to take home with me. There was also a show last night by Trooper Amy, who was doing songs and that, which I've filmed for you. She was really good. And we also, don't know how, but we ended up with this little tiny triceratops on the table. Don't know where it came from, but it just ended up there. Well, we couldn't just leave it there. Look how cute it is. Anyway, that's enough of that. Today, though, day 7, we are going actual souvenir hunting. Going to look through some of the shops. I'd like to have a look at a closer look down the field at the end, because on the first day here, I showed you like a quick view, and it had some sheep in it, but I've also seen cows in it from time to time. I just thought, I'll go down, have a look, see what's on there. So souvenir hunting, looking at the field, maybe going to the beach again, seeing what the weather's like, and maybe doing some swimming this afternoon, if we're in the mood. But anyway, I'll let the footage continue now. This is the same view I took when we were at the fun fair, except this time tide is out. And people, oh, it's just gone down now, but people were on that terrifying ride that I went on. Seems to really like that flower. There's also quite a few on this one over here. There's a whole bunch of them. Even over here, in this yellow one. Is that a bee? It's a bee. No, no, no. Okay, back calm. Bees gone. A whole bunch of little birds sat on the air. Really? Just wondering how close we'll get before they all go flying. Just down here on the beach after our walk down from the fun fair, getting some souvenirs. And of course, got an ice cream because, you know, couldn't resist. Got a plain with a flake and some strawberry sauce on it. And the sun's come out. Hallelujah. Haha, filming from a different section of the caravan this time. Normally I film over there, now I'm filming over here. Please forgive the hair. I've just gotten out of the swimming baths and I haven't had a chance to wash it yet. But what I wanted to say is, something funny that keeps happening every time we go swimming, because anyone who knows me will tell you that I spend 80% of my time swimming underwater at the bottom of the pool. I've been doing that a lot lately at our pool, at this Ty Mawr pool, and people, one person was like, oh my god, what is that? Actually, about three people were like that on separate occasions. One actually said, what's that? And mum was like, it's somebody swimming, and then it came up and I they were like, oh, and I was like, what just happened? Another one was a kid today. He turned around, he saw me at the bottom of the pool. I took a few, because he was walking down it, and then saw me, and then was like backing up like, what is that? Because it's just a black puddle at the bottom of the pool. Oh, but it's happened on three occasions, and it's been really funny. Also, I wanted to tell you a bit more about the comedian that we had last night. Because another thing I remembered was every time he tried to pronounce Ty Mawr, he pronounced it in a different way. To, like, sort of like, it was like Ty Mawr and then Ty Mawr. And then it would get like to Ty Mawr and then just trail off. Also, earlier on, while I was at the beach and enjoying life and this, that and the other, I seem to have caught the sun a little bit. Can you tell? This is the slightly tan bit. This is the stuff that got happened today. This is the other stuff. And you can tell this is today, because you've got that perfect line and this gap here where this has been sort of like that. It's the same on this side. I'm just hoping that, you know, it'll clear up or whatever. It doesn't hurt or anything, so I don't know if it's sunburn or not. Oh well. But yeah, we're just going to get some food from the fish and chippery, as they call it, so the chippy, to see out what the food's like there, because it's the last night. And I'm hoping to film some stuff from the, what I know is the Sparky store, but it's also like the beach shack or something now, because I realised you guys haven't seen it. And it's also got figurines in it from another show which I've got up on my channel, which is Super Squad Heroes. It's got figurines of some of the characters on it, which I thought was cool. So I'll cut to probably the food next, and then straight to the store. There was more chips than this, but I've eaten a few because I forgot I said I was going to film it. But there wasn't many chips. I suppose they make it up. Make up for the size of it with the sausage hot dog thing, whatevs. I said I'd show you it, so there it is. This is what I was all about. Don't have any specs though. Oh no, no specs is there. Oh no, it's more Loxy, never mind. Oh well. Before we carry on, we need more people on this earth tour, and we have an easy way to do that. And that is called a conga. So we're a team, you're gonna follow me. You're a team, you're gonna follow that thing over there. That's it. Yeah, it does a thing. So, you're going to follow me, so red team, here we go. Everybody,
why else are you following me?
Hurry up, so aren't you involved as well, because if you're not,
I'm going to come and get you.
Here we go. Follow me, then. Slush and millions.
I'm going to follow you. Click the red
team. Lots of stuff down there as well. Including a clown. Follow the red team, everybody following me. Hurry up, come on, get yourselves on. I've got the balls you need to wait all this over. That's it, we need to get on. And you can tell me on the red team as we go. This is what I've been doing to keep all the light out of my bedroom. And if you can't tell what it is, oh, it is the sofa cushions from the living room. Because otherwise all the light just gets in. And I can't sleep with it being bright. Oh my god, it's so bright. Oh, ooh, it's lovely and toasty though. Ooh. Just hug the cushion while it's warm. Well, we're here at the coach station 45 minutes early because we rang the number for the taxi service and got no answer. So we thought we'll grab the bus, and here's me panicking. So I'm like, let's leave now. So we're here very early. But I'm going to tell you about last night's entertainment, because there was a game for the Madison Mayhem where they had six adults on the stage and all the kids with them. And there was this one guy who was quite unlucky, because on his end, he had about four kids with him. And what the game was, is the kids would pass a pie to each other up and down the line. Once you got to the end, you'd spin round before you could pass it back again. And wherever the music stopped, that adult then got a pie to the face. And there was, as I said, one guy with four kids, so he was really unlucky, and unfortunately he was out first. But there was this one girl, and we were just sat there going, I really hope she doesn't win this, because she had like, she was very sort of like, oh my god, I can't get my hair messed up or my face messed up. I've worked ages and hours on my makeup, and even when it came here time to get pie, she had her hands in front of her face, and it was like, no, you don't get to do that. You don't get to do that. If everybody else is getting pie on your face, you're getting pie on your face too. But there was also another party game where the team stars, troopers, had to run from the stage to the audience to get the answer of some sort of like, it'd be a celebrity with like a filter on them, and you had to guess who it was. But the lads were having fun because it was Zach and Tommy doing it, and they kept running towards the stage and then like shuffling the bell further towards their half of the stage, to the point where like they were like, no, and like Zach did like an action roll up onto the stage to they grab the bell and take it away. And he said, like, look at the sweat patch on the floor. Look at it. That's how much effort I'm putting to this. And he's like, we should sit down. Both lie down on the floor. And who has the biggest sweat angel? And Tommy turned around and went, well, it's obviously going to be you. And he's like, are you calling me fat? But there was also entertainment on last night. We had a singer who I've got some footage of. Not much, because I didn't want to, like, make this video too long. And I also got photographs with the troopers. But yeah, now we're just waiting for the coach and then we'll be on our way home. So I hope you've enjoyed today's video and have a nice day.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Oh, boys and girls on the dance floor, you are amazing. Grown-ups at the back, I think we can do a little bit better. Good evening.
Good evening.
So much better. How are we all doing tonight? Are we good? Well, my name is Ella Coleman, I'm going to be singing you some songs. Hopefully a little bit of something for everybody. We're going to do a random mix. We kicked it off, who was first? A little bit of Ed Sheeran. Oh yes, brilliant. Hope you all enjoyed that one, singing along. This next one I'm going to do is a bit of an older one. Sorry, kids. This is called My Guy. Enjoy.
Take me away from my God. I'm better today that can take me.